I'm working on a spreadsheet that contains a number of different salespeople and the amount that they sold each month. And I need a way of visualizing these numbers so I can easily see how each salesperson is doing month to month. I could just put them all into one big chart, but while this may look cool, it's not exactly easy to read, and it would be almost impossible to pinpoint a specific salesperson on this chart. Luckily, in Excel 2010, there's another option called Sparklines that will allow us to give each salesperson a separate miniature chart that fits into a single cell. In this case, we'll be putting a sparkline on each row, so it'll be right next to its source data. To get started, select the data for a single sparkline. In most cases, that will mean a single row or column. And then on the Insert tab, there is a Sparklines group that has commands for the three different types: Line, Column, and Win-Loss. I'll select Line. And we just need to select the location for the Sparkline, which will be the cell right next to our selection. And there's our first Sparkline. We'll copy this the same way that we copy a formula, by dragging the fill handle. Now all of these rows have sparklines, and it's easy to see whether sales are increasing or decreasing for each employee. For example, David Carlson's sales are trending upward, but Elizabeth Ferguson's sales are trending downward. Let's make some changes to the sparklines to make them stand out a little better. If you want to make them larger, you can just make all of the rows taller, and the sparklines will stretch to fit them. Then select any sparkline, it doesn't matter which one, and the Design tab will appear with a number of different sparkline tools that you can use to modify them, and if you ever need to delete them, then you can just use the Clear command. In the Show group, there are some options that let you highlight certain points, and probably the most useful ones are High Point and Low Point, and I also like First Point and Last Point. Now I know there are no negative points in this worksheet, so I won't worry about those. And markers will highlight every single point, which may make it look a little too cluttered. It may be helpful to choose a style that has a little more contrast. I like this one because it makes the High Point and Low Point green and red, which really makes them stand out. In the Type group, you can change the type of sparkline that you're using. Column is usually a good choice, and it'll work with most types of data. Win-Loss will basically just show whether the values are positive or negative, but it won't actually show how low or high the values are. And since I don't have any negative values here, that's not as useful. So I'll just use Column. Now there's one important thing that you need to know about how Excel displays sparklines. By default, each sparkline is sort of stretched to fit its own cell. So the maximum value will go up to the top of the cell, and the minimum will be at the very bottom. The problem with this is it doesn't show you how high or low the values are compared to the other sparklines. For example, all of these maximum values look the same, even though the values may be very different, and this can be misleading. To fix this, go to the Axis command, and you can see that the minimum and maximum options are set to automatic. And you'll need to change both of these to same for all sparklines. And now we can see that the maximum in this sparkline is much higher than the maximum in this one. Compared to traditional charts, sparklines offer a very different approach to visualizing data, and depending on what type of project you're working on, you may prefer one or the other. And sometimes, to get the most complete picture, you may even choose to use both.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCF. learnfree.org.